Hello, everyone. Sunday Adelaja here. Nice to see all of you. Welcome back. Hope you are all okay. Hope you're getting the notification. Nice to see you all. Shagun Fatuma, welcome. Oh, today is going to be a glorious day. It's going to be a glorious, glorious, wonderful session. So I want to encourage you, if you are there, go look for anybody you know, everyone you know. Go look for them, and you want to make them come or invite them to come to listen to this message, because it is going to be memorable. It's going to be memorable. And it's going to be life-changing. It's going to absolutely be life-changing. No doubt about it. So go get your friends. Go get your people. Anybody you care about. Go get them. And of course, let's begin to share the link. Because if you share the link, you'll be able to have a copy of it. So share the link and let a copy of it go to your timeline. Go to your Facebook page. So that you don't miss out on this one. It's going to be a huge session of blessing, of grace. So welcome, everyone. Go share the link. Let's go share this link right now. And And if you care for anybody or about anyone, go call them. That's my advice for you. That's my advice for you. Go call on them. They will need it, and you will need it too. Someone is going to be very happy that you share this link with them. Someone is going to be very grateful to you that you share this with them. Okay, the topic for today is, through work, we discover the treasure and genius in us. Through work, you can discover the treasure in you. Can you believe it? Oh, wow. Friends, if you could imagine how much treasure you carry in yourself, if you can just imagine how much treasure is in you, we all carry so much treasure in us. You have so much treasure in you, you won't believe it. But you will never discover these treasures until you begin to work really hard. There are so many great things in you, so much diamonds, so much gold, so much treasure, so much brilliance, so much genius, so much great things in you. Oh, how I wish you could discover them. But work is God's great gift. Work is God's great gift for us to discover ourselves. And not just to discover ourselves, but to discover the treasure, all the treasure in us. God is so kind. God has been so kind. God is so wonderful. God is so generous. God is so good to you. God is so good to me. God has been so good. So good. He created and invented work. We should all be grateful every day for God for work. We should all be praying to God Almighty, thanking Him, if not for anything, but at least for work. You should be thanking God for work. You should be grateful to God that He has invented this wonderful blessing that He is now giving to all of us, the blessing of work. Because apart from many other things that I could say about work, and apart from all the things I've already said about work, one of the greatest blessings of work, one of the greatest blessings of work, and one of the reasons why God invented it is for me. It's for me. It's for you. It's for all of us to get to know who we are. It's for all of us to discover the brilliance that God had put in us. It's for all of us to discover the ingenuity that God has put in us. God invented work for you to begin to believe that you are a genius. God invented work for you to begin to believe that you are precious. God invented work for you to discover yourself. God invented work for you to discover your value. Man, you are more valuable than you could imagine. You are so precious. You are so valuable. It's mind-blowing. Nobody should be telling you how precious you are. Nobody should be telling you how great you are. But when you discover the secret and the power of work, when you begin to work hard, when you begin to work on yourself, when you begin to engage yourself in the three dimensions of work, when you begin to work on yourself mentally, when you begin to work on yourself intellectually, when you begin to, that's the same as mentally, when you begin to work on yourself spiritually, when you begin to work on yourself physically, wow, you will discover that you are a great fellow and that you are a great gift waiting to be unveiled to the world, that you are a great blessing that has been packaged from heaven to bless his generation, and it's just a pity that you have not known about it. And the only thing that you need to do to get to discover this, your ingenuity and this, your blessing to the world, is just for you to get to work, to discover work, to discover work, to discover work. Now, the Bible says in Psalm 139 verse 14, we all know what is there. It says that I will praise you, O Lord, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. You are wonderful. You are beautiful. You are wonderfully made. You are fearfully made. Now, but how do you discover that? Only through work. Without work, you will never discover your treasure. Without work, you will never discover your awesomeness. Without work, you will never discover your uniqueness. Without work, you will never ever discover your greatness. Without work, you will ever ever discover your ingenuity, your genius. Without work, you will never even really know how precious you are. Without work, you will not even begin to imagine how valuable you are, not just to God, but to humanity, to your world, and to yourself. But with work, everything comes rolling. Everything comes rolling. Let me give you an example of that. In the Bible, you know, when God put Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, they never knew they were geniuses. They never knew they were geniuses until God gave them an assignment to work. Shagagabagababa. One of the greatest misfortunes and one of the greatest failures and disservices you could render yourself is to render yourself jobless. When I talk about work and job, I'm not talking about going to get a job. I'm not talking about going for unemployment. That's not the kind of job I'm talking about. When I'm talking about work, I'm talking about working on yourself. I'm talking about working in your field, in your area of calling. I'm talking about working to add value to other people and working to add value to yourself. So when I'm talking about work, I'm talking about using work to accomplish your purpose and your destiny on earth. And when I talk, anytime I talk about work, don't get me wrong, I'm not talking about employment at all. I'm not talking about job, and I'm not talking about salary. I'm just talking about work as an entity, as a reality of life, all right? As one of the greatest blessings that God has given to us. So one of the greatest deprivation you could give to yourself is not to work. that the greatest work you could do is to work on yourself. Is the work on yourself. You know, so if you don't work, there's no proof that you hate yourself as much as when you don't work. The greatest way, the biggest way for you to prove your hatred to your own self is to refuse to work. And not work for salary, because you could be working for salary, you could be going to work, you could be having a job and still not work. That's not what I'm talking about. When I talk about work, I'm not talking about your job or your salary. When you're working, that is for job, that's not work for me. When you are having employment, that is as far as I'm concerned, that is not work. That's not the work I'm talking about. The work I'm talking about is when you are working to fulfill purpose. The work that I'm talking about is when you are working, when you are busy working to fulfill your destiny, to work on yourself, to work on improving yourself, to work on improving others, to work on adding value or creating value, creating a product for yourself or goods, or that is what work is. Okay, so Adam never discovered he was a genius. Adam never discovered he was unique until he got a job from God. It was only when God took Adam to the Garden of Eden and gave him a job description to do, and told him, he started bringing the animals to him, and when he brought all the animals to him, and he said, I want you to begin to work on these animals. I want you to begin to think and to bring out the names for each and every one of these animals. It is only in the process of that work, when he named the first animal, it worked out for him. He named the second one, it worked out. He named the 100th one, it worked out. He named the 1,000th one, it worked out. 10,000 one, it worked out. 1,000,000 one, it worked out. Then he discovered, wow, I am able to name not just one animal, but 1,000,000, 1,000,000,000, 10,000,000,000. His genius was discovered. His genius was triggered. His uniqueness was discovered. The same thing. There are so much in you. There is so much greatness buried in every individual. Even by the mere fact that you are made by God, and God is a great God, and His seed is in you. Even by the mere fact that His nature is in you. Even by the mere fact that He made you in His likeness and His image. And He is the great God of the universe. He is the ruler of the earth. And He is in you. Even by that mere fact alone, it is a disservice for yourself not to even be able to do something great, something, you know, marvelous, something incredible, something awesome, something vast, something incredibly big. It is in you. But the reason why you have not discovered this is because you have not worked enough on yourself. You have not worked enough on discovery. You have not taxed yourself. You have not pushed yourself to the corner. You have not pushed yourself to the limit. You have not pushed yourself enough. There is so much brilliance in you. And I will use different examples to discover that. Adam discovered his brilliance because he started to work. Adam discovered his brilliance because he started to work. Adam discovered his genius and ingenuity because he started to work. The same thing happened to David. You see, the brothers of David were mocking him and thinking that he was a strange guy. But he was a boy that loved to work. David was a boy that loved to work. He made the biggest discovery of his life. If you would love to work, if you would love to work, my God. If you would just love to work. If you would dare love to work. My. If you would dare fall in love with hard work, working 14, 18 hours a day, you will never have to pray for success in life. You will never have to pray for miracles. You will never have to take any prophetic offering. You will never have to take any breakthrough offering. You will never have to go and be looking for some prophets to decide your destiny. If you will ever fall in love with work, to work 18 hours a day, success is going to be sheep. there will be nothing as easy and as cheap to you as success. It's going to be the easiest thing to do in law in the world. It's going to be the easiest thing to do in the world. God bless every human being. God has blessed every human being with this singular wealth. This is one of the greatest wealth that God has given to humanity. And this wealth is the wealth of work. And work did not just come after the fall of man. Work is not a consequence of sin. God himself, we ourselves, we discover the brilliance of God because he worked. When God began to work to create the universe, we began to discover his brilliance. When God started in the process of God creating the whole world, we began to discover his greatness. We discover the greatness of God through his work. We discover the brilliance of God because it worked. We discover the awesomeness or the almightiness, the majesty of God because it worked. If work causes us to discover the greatness of God, your own greatness as well will be discovered only through work and by work. If through work and only by work we discovered the brilliance and the genius and the ingenuity of God, yours will not be an exception. It is only through and by hard work that we will discover your ingenuity, that we will discover your brilliance, that we will discover your greatness and your uniqueness. Because of work, David, he went to the field. Thanks to that hard work, he became the shepherd of Israel. Because of hard work and the desire to work, and because he loved to work, he was able to kill that bear and the lion. And because he had trained himself in the acts of war, which is a form of work as well, in fighting, in war, warfare, because he was so skillful in what in fighting and in warfare, he was able to defeat the biggest nemesis of his nation. Some of the biggest nemesis, some of the biggest challenges of your nation are at your dove foot right now. Some of the greatest challenges of your nation are at your door front. You are the one to confront them. You are the one to confront the problems of unemployment in your country and bring a lasting solution. But you have to do it through work. Some of you have been created by God, sent here by God to bring answer to the problem of unemployment, to the problem of corruption, to the problem of political instability, to the problem of economic dilemma, to the problem of economic growth, prosperity in your country, in your nation, and in the world at large. But you will never get there without falling in love with work. It is through work and by hard work that you will be able to release all the greatness that God has buried in you, all the ingenuity that God has put in you. At your doorstep lie the answers to the questions of your country, of your continent, of your world, of the body of Christ. But until you love to push yourself to the limit, until you fall in love with walking and walking your socks out, until you begin to push yourself away from all people, all kind of people who waste your time, until you push yourself away from people that just distract you left and right, until you pull yourself from the vanity and the frivolity of life, you will never really be able to discover that the greatness is in you, that greatness is already in you. Listen closely. There are no people who are better than you. There is no one who is better than you. There is no one who is better than you, both now and in history. There is no one who is better than you, both now and in history. There is no one who is better than you, both now and in history. There is no one who is better than you, both now and in history. They only work better than you, or smarter than you. The only loved work, work better than you, smarter than you. Let me tell you something. Geniuses are not born. God doesn't give birth to geniuses. Or let me say it the other way. God only gives birth to geniuses. God only gives birth to geniuses. All of us are geniuses, potentially. But the only some were able to discover their ingenuity, but some were not able to. you will discover your genius. You will discover your genius. You will discover your greatness, your ingenuity through work and only by work. Not by going to work physically, only at some construction site and things like that. No, the greatest amount of work you ever have to do is to add value to yourself. Working on yourself, working to add value to yourself, working to create value for others, and working to create a product of value or a service of value. You know, let me tell you my story, how I discover the treasure in me through work. You know, before I discover the secret and the power of work, I used to be one of the last students in my class. As a matter of fact, in my primary school years, they started teaching me to read when I was 4 or 5. I couldn't just get it. I went to primary class 1, I couldn't just learn to read. Primary 2, class 2, I couldn't start to read. Class 3, I couldn't start to read. Class 4, I couldn't start to read. It was only when I was 10 years old that I first learned to read. I was so dull, I didn't even know how I got to that class 4. But it's not because I was dull, but because everybody was telling me that they were hitting me in the head and saying, you are so dull. But they didn't just want to consider that maybe they were supposed to have applied a new method of teaching and training for me. My own method of learning is through critical thinking. I don't reason like every other person. I don't like to reason just straight line. I like to chart my own way. I like to, chart my own path. I like to, get my own way. But you see, they didn't understand that, and they wanted me to just learn like every other person. Well, I became the worst student. But one day, my sister told me something. And told me that she showed me a scripture, Deuteronomy 28:13, that we all could become the head and not the tail, the first and not last. And I couldn't believe it. I said, "Is that possible for me too?" He said, "Yeah, God said it." I said, "God said this in concerning people in Africa also, in this village. Does God even know that this village exists?" And to cut the long story short, I prayed with her and I said, "Okay. If now God is saying that I could become everything and I'm praying for him to help me, for me not to be the one that would let God down and disappoint God, maybe I should begin to work on it." So I, for the first time, decided to begin to work, because my sister also told me another thing that motivated me strongly. She said, if you don't pass this year, it was a year before my WAEC, my school leaving certificate. If you don't pass your school leaving certificate, you will remain in this village forever. And you just become a farmer and one of the lost people in this village. And you never get out of this village. Ooh, that got me thinking. So I took a decision to be reading. I was running away from my friends, hiding from them, just to go and put on my lantern and my candle, my local candle, and then I would go and hide. And what was I doing? Each time I would hide and make sure that I read 3 hours into the night, to the 3 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the night, 3 o'clock in the morning, I would just read and study. And thank God I did that. After doing that for 1 year, I discovered that, because I always used to think that mathematics was not my thing, that I was dull in mathematics. I just heard people saying mathematics is not my subject. So I thought mathematics is not in our family. That's what my brother used to say. And I discovered mathematics was the easiest subject, because I didn't know just the formula, remember it, and apply it to other cases. I was so surprised, because I thought, because of the way I used to think, I used to think that when they give you a mathematical assignment, that you need to think of the formula, make up the formula all by yourself, that you need to, think it up. So I like to think things up by myself, but I didn't know that I needed to, just copy a formula. That was so easy. So I began to do well. This was in Idomila. I was living alone in my house in Idomila, and I began to run away from my friends and going to study. So I, after 1 year of studying like that, you can't believe it. I became one of the best students in the school. And when the school certificate exam came out, I got the best, one of the best results. Just one guy had one more credit than me, but I'll get one of the best results in that school. And you couldn't believe it. And I was the only one who won scholarship to study abroad. You know, I before then, I had been thinking that all the top students that were there with me for all these years, who were always taking the number one, second, third position, I thought they were geniuses. I thought they were born genius. I thought these people were genius by God. I thought, you know, I was dull. I was born dull, and I was born a failure in life, and they were born to be smart. I didn't know that nobody is born specially smart. Nobody is born to be specially to be a genius. That all of us are geniuses in our own way. All of us are born special in our own way. All of us have the potential. But it was only when I began to walk deep into the night, till 2 o'clock in the night, till 3 o'clock in the morning, till 4 o'clock in the morning, just in the night, in darkness, when I began to work hard, I discovered my ingenuity. When I began to work hard, I discovered that I was no worse than them. I discovered that I could even be better than them. And I beat all of them in the university. I mean, in the school. And now I'm doing better than all of them in life. I'm doing better probably than most of the people in my generation right now. Not just from my country, but in the world. You see, why that? Because I discovered, but before I was the same person, but when I was not working hard, I was working out in the field. I was doing farming and, you know, carrying firewood. But I was not working for self-development. You see, the work that I'm talking about is not the hard physical work. When I talk about work, I'm talking about self-development. It was when I started working on myself, when I started adding value to myself, that I discovered that that is the greatest amount, that's the greatest form of work. And that work discovered, unveiled in me the ingenuity, the greatness, the awesomeness, and the genius that was hiding in me. I never knew about it. Well, you know what I think? I'm still going to tell you a few stories now. I'm going to tell you a few stories now that will be so instrumental. They will blow up your mind, and they will really help you and help your children or your siblings, anybody you know. So before we go ahead, I want to ask you to do something. Everyone that is watching me now, please go right now and look for your share button. Go right now and look for your share button, all right? You should have your share button under the video. Go and press it. Press that share button. Share it so that you could have a copy of this message. You need to have a copy of this message, and the only way to do it is by pressing the share button. Okay, press the share button. If you need to go back to your timeline, go quickly and go and do that right now while I still make one more announcement. Go to your timeline, go and press the share button so that you could have a copy of this message. You must have a copy, and so that you could share it with others as well. But this is going to be very memorable. Let me tell you something else. There is treasure in you. So much treasure in you. You are not worse than Einstein. You are not worse than Isaac Newton. Isaac Newton is not having much more treasure in you. I mean, in them than in you, that you have in yourself. You are not worse than any of the great names you've ever heard about. You are not worse than any one of them. You are not worse. You are as great inside. But the difference, they went ahead and locked, pushed themselves to the limit. And they were all able to unveil the greatness in them. If you don't push yourself through hard work as well, you will never know in this lifetime that you have been no better, that nobody is better than you. You will never know that they are no better than you. You will never discover all the things you could have done. Oh my, don't wait till you die and go to heaven before you discover your treasure. Don't wait till you die and go to heaven before you discover all the, you know, preciousness, all the gold, all the virtues, and all the diamonds that are hidden in you. My God, if you could just take a decision to work extra hours and to work 14 hours minimum a day or 18 hours minimum a day, adding value to yourself or creating your product of value, tilling your own gland of promise, you will not imagine it, that you will become a household name in your world. You will become a household name in your country. You will be able to bring a solution to something, to one question. All the problems of your country, they are waiting for a deliverer. They are waiting for somebody to bring a solution. And it it is you. There is that solution buried in you. But until you begin to work very, very hard, you will not discover it. Well, when you know, then I discovered. So that amount, that thing, by working hard, but my YX result made me to discover that I was not worse than anybody, that I had treasure in me. Then, in my university days, everybody was always afraid of JAMB. That was admission to university. I took chose one of the best universities that time, University of Ife, and to my surprise, I was coming from a village where I never saw a library, where I never saw a laboratory, where I never had school teachers, where I went to a school that didn't have walls, didn't have roof. I mean, just a very down kind of village school. And when I finished my JAMB, I got the third best result in my faculty. It's unbelievable. Only two people were better than me in the whole country. And I couldn't believe it. So it made me to know, because I was working hard. Because if in the university, if in the high school, I was just studying 3 hours. But now I started studying 4 hours every day. Then I got a good result in the JAMB, you know. And then I came to Ukraine, I came to Russia. I came to a university where we had 16,000 students from 100 countries, from 99 countries. And I said, my God, I was so afraid of traveling abroad because, you know, in some of us in Africa, we used to think that how will I ever be able to compete with a white man? I might not be able to make it. How will I be able to compete with white man? How will I able to, I didn't speak the language. How will I ever be able to speak this language and used to compete with them in their own language? Can you imagine me going to university? I came here 1 year of language school, and then from language school right to the university. Just 1 year, having learned the language 1 year, now I have to go and study, not in high school, not in primary school, go and study in university and competing with the locals. That's their native language. I was so afraid. And you know, even before then, before I left Africa, some of us used to think that white people are better than Europeans, were better than Africans, and I was just so afraid. How will I be able? Will I be able to cope? Will I be able to compete with Europeans? Then my European professor came and said, because you came late to school, you know, you have missed so much, you will never be able to catch up. And the man said, I've been teaching in university for so long. I have experience. I know my job. Yeah, I know people who can make it and people who cannot make it. With your accent and with your language and with your lateness and everything, all these things combined, if you will never speak Russian language. If you speak this language, you say you are a Christian, even God cannot help you. If you speak this language, I will go to church and believe in God as well. But even God cannot help. And I was so challenged. I said, my God, if this professor is saying even God cannot help me. But I remember, God reminded me. You remember that it's not the word of professor that decides. It's not even the prophecy of a prophet that decides. It's not even something. It's not even the prayers that decide. It is one factor that decides. If you could work hard, rely on God, pray hard as if work cannot do anything, but also work hard as if you have not prayed at all. If you could believe God, pray hard, believe God, but more important, if you just believe and pray hard and you don't go to work hard, nothing will work out. So God challenged me that, you remember when you were in secondary school, you discovered that you had treasure in yourself by working 3 hours every day, and you became better than all the students. Now, challenge yourself, increase that to 6 hours. So I vowed to myself that I was going to lock myself up in the library after school every day. Does not matter how long we stay in school. It does not matter how long we stay in classes. Even if we stay in classes for 10 hours, after that 10 hours, I will still go and lock myself up in the library and pray and read and study for another 6 hours. I did that for the next 7 years of my life in the university. As a result, I did not just speak Russian language, I graduated as the best student in that university in the last 25 years. 25 years after I finished university, nobody has broken my record. Because why? Because I locked myself, I pushed myself to the limit. And from Monday to Friday, no matter what schedule I had, I will go to the library and lock myself in there. And even if I feel sleeping, I will sleep there. Even if I feel hungry, I will eat there. I will not leave. I pushed myself for 7 years. I was doing this. By the time I did it for 7 years, I beat every student, every Russian speaking student student. I beat every student from every country. I beat every student from 99 other countries. I beat all the 16,000 students. I became the best student ever. And after, I discover another thing, that wow. So it's not my village that decides if I'm going to be successful or not. It's not my biography that decides. It's not my background that decides. It's not my mother couldn't read. My mother never read anything. She never could read in Russian, in English or even Yoruba language. She could never knew how to read. She never could read. She never could write. And I never even spoke English before I left my native Africa, my native Nigeria. So none of that matters if I could just discover the secret of hard work. I got another revelation. Nothing can beat hard work. God has given every one of us equal gifts and equal blessings, equal resources. And the name of that resource is hard work. God has blessed us equally. God has blessed us equally. God has blessed you. He has given you the key not to be worse than Martin Luther. He has given you the key that you will not be worse than JF Kennedy. He has given you the key that you should not be worse than Bill Gates. He has given you the key that you should not be worse than Steve Jobs. He has given you the key, and the key is hard work on yourself. You know, the power of hard work. If you, through hard work, you discover that there's so much treasure. I discovered my geniosity through hard work in secondary school. Then I discovered my geniosity through my ingenuity through hard work in the university exams. Then I discovered among 100 students, my treasures in my own eyes started growing. My value in my own eyes started growing as well. So in the university, we had people from 99 countries. I discovered my treasure, my ingenuity. I discovered that I was gifted. I was loved by God. I'm capable to do something. Before, I thought I was not capable of doing anything. Everybody was kicking me in the head, beating me in the head, and saying, "You will never amount to anything in life. You will always be in this village. You will clean somebody's shoes for them. You will never be this. You will never be that." But there is no human being in the world that is created to be a failure. There is no human being in the world that doesn't have a strings of genius in them. There is no human being in the world that is not a genius. I know that for sure, because I couldn't even read or write till I was 10 years old. I thought I was the worst of the worst, and because this is what everybody told me around. But in the real sense, if you could discover, if you could lock yourself up in the laboratory, if you could lock yourself up in the laboratory 18 hours a day, 14 hours a day, and work continuously for so long, you will discover that Michelangelo is not a genius, that you are just as good as Michelangelo. You will discover that, you know, Beethoven is not a genius, that you are just as good as Beethoven. You will discover that, you know, Sir Isaac Newton is not a genius, that you are just another one like them. You will discover that Thomas Edison is not a genius, that he's just a human being like you, that you are just one like them, that you will discover that nobody is better than you. If you could put yourself into the secret of God's blessing that he has given unto us, if you could discover this great secret of hard work, then God called me to become to be a pastor. So I started the church. You know what everybody was telling me in Europe here? That don't even bother trying to get white people. Because in Russia here, no black man was leading any white people. Not just in Russia, even all over Europe, white people don't follow black men. Even in America, look at the big names. T.D. Jakes, T.D. Jakes, and all the black people, even no matter how good they are, black, white men don't follow them. White people don't follow them. You, no matter how good you are, that's what people tell you. No matter how good you are, you will never be able to get white people to follow you. But this one, it was too late. It was too late. By this time, I had discovered the secret of ingenuity. I had discovered the secret of all success. By this time, nobody could deceive me. I was leading a fellowship that time that was just consisting of Africans and Asians. So I gave up on that fellowship. I left that fellowship. I left that fellowship. I gave it to another person. And I started going on a journey. The journey of discovery through hard work. My own journey of discovery through hard work. My own journey of discovery. I started working on how I could get the attention of the white men. And then I discovered that the white men are not so sentimental like the black people are. So I discovered that for me to get them, I must be there. I must develop my logic and thinking faculty. I must discover my brain. Because white people here in Europe, they like logic. I must be able to present my arguments very logically. Number two, I must be able to reason on their level. I must be able to know how to use scientific facts. I must be able to know how to use historic facts. I must be able to back out everything I said. White people, they don't like to at least follow you if you cannot back up what you are saying. If there are no proofs, they want everything to be proven. Instead of, like I used to do, you know, instead of what people do in Africa, people follow mainly because of emotions and because of sentiments and all that. But I discovered that most white Europeans that I know, they like to use arguments and logics and proofs. So I developed myself in that. Then I discovered that my accent was a problem with the Russian people. So I developed my accent and developed my language. And you know, I started adding value to myself anyhow I could. Then not just physically and mentally, but I started also adding value to working more hard with God, to, you know, doing spiritual work, to be able to even become greater through spiritually. So I started working with God. I started even locking myself up every day, 6 hours a day, working with God, learning and praying and discovering more of God for myself, so that I could reveal God better, so that I could manifest God better, so that I could become more like God. I know that if I could become more like God, if I could resemble God, if I could carry God, though there is nobody that could be able to walk away from me. Then I also worked hard on discovering how to hear God better. I started hearing God. That really brought the change. When I started hearing God, that brought all the change. And you know what? Well, in the next 1 year after I started our church, for four years I was living in Russia, living in Europe, and I could not get one white person to follow me. 4 years I couldn't get one person. But after I worked hard, walked out of myself, I began to hear the voice of God, and I began to implement it. I discovered my greatness again. I discovered my ingenuity. I discovered that there is a treasure. I unveiled that treasure through hard work. And you know what? In the next 1 year, we're having 1,000 people. In the another 1 year, we're having 2,000. Then in the next 8 years, to cut the long story short, we're having 15,000 people. Then 20,000 people. Then 25,000 people. And the rest is history. At 33, I built the largest church in Europe. And 99.9 people in my church are white Europeans. And how do you mention that? How did that come about? I was thinking God did it. God has to do it. That's what most people say. God has to do it. Let's go pray to God. God has to do it. No, God has already put everything in you. God has already put everything in you. God has already put all his greatness in you. He said you have all things in you. He said in him there is the fullness of God. In you is in you the hope of glory. He is in you the fullness of him that filleth everything. Thing is in you. God has already put everything in you. In fact, he went ahead to say, the kingdom of God itself is in you as well. You know, the kingdom of God is in you. So why don't you just, you know, discover that? You can discover the kingdom that is in you. You can discover the, you know, the wisdom of God that is in you. God is in you. So instead of you to just rely on God and praying to God outside and looking outside and asking God, give me this, do this for me, give me this. Don't waste God's time. Don't waste God's time. Go and invest in yourself. Go and work hard, and you will discover that everything is already on earth, and everything is already inside of you. There is nothing you cannot become. There is no one. So I discovered that by the age of 33, I was leading the biggest evangelical church in Europe. And from this background that I had, there is no limit for you if you will work hard. Hard work is the blessing that God has given unto us, through which we could discover ourselves, through which we could discover our ingenuity, through which we could discover all the treasure that is in us. Hard work is the key. Hard work is the key. If you will work, I bet anybody that if you work 14, 18 hours a day, adding value to yourself, if you work to improve yourself 14, 18 hours a day, that you will never be ordinary on the earth. You will be leaders among men. You will be shining light, shining bright among, no matter what area. If you you lock yourself up into the laboratory or in the library 18, 14 hours a day, there is no way you will not rule in your world. There is no limit. There is no limit to your success if you will just discover the secret of hard work. Then I became a preacher. But I was thinking, I'm just a local champion. Who knows me? Who knows an African pastor in the backyard of communism? I'm just here. I never spoke English. I never preached in English. I never even spoke English before I left my country. I was thinking, how will I ever be able to make sense to people outside of Ukraine? Because I'm only used to preaching in Russian. I'm only used to preaching in Russian language. I would never be able to preach in English. Then somebody, one man that I respect so much, is one of the top five leaders in Africa, in Nigeria. He decided to invite me because he came here, ministered, and saw what I was doing. He said, you are the most hidden secret in the world. You are the most hidden secret in the world. So he said, come and speak for me in Africa. I was so nervous. I was so nervous. So I knew that it's going to take a year. For that year, I worked on myself again. I worked on myself intellectually. I worked on myself spiritually. I worked to know God better, to hear God better, to be closer to God, to carry God better. I started doing my solitude. 1 week, lock myself up for 1 week in a month. Every single month, I would lock myself up for a week. And in that 1 week, every day from 14 to 18 hours, I would just be, studying, praying, and, soaking myself in God's presence. And by the time I went to that place to preach, I was thinking, maybe I should just start with some small churches to go and preach somewhere. Why should I go and start to preach in this big conference? You know what? When after I finished speaking, that big man of God was asking to take my notes, was asking for my, I had my exercise book where I had all my revelations in there, was asking to copy some of my revelations. And before I even left, he couldn't hold it. He was preaching. He was invited to go and preach for Idahosa. We were there together. He was preaching my message right in my presence. I couldn't believe it. And I knew, I discovered that I was not worse than any preacher in Africa. That all the big men I'm hearing about, that they were not better than me if I could just discover. Before, I used to look at this man, I used to think that they were God. I used to think that I would never stand on the same stage with them. But when I worked on myself, I discovered the treasure in myself, that I was actually not worse than anybody else. Then I met my friend, who became my best friend, Miles Monroe. That was the first person that blew my mind. So I developed myself so much that I couldn't even learn from anyone. Not that I didn't want to learn. I was learning. I was trying to learn from preachers. I could learn from other subjects, but from preachers, it was like they all remained in the past. It was like nothing new was coming from the pulpit, and nobody to learn from. All of them were just repeating each other. Then I listened to Miles Monroe. I couldn't believe it. The guy blew me up. He just challenged me. I discovered one person in the whole wide world that I could listen to and still learn. Then I began to invite him here. I began to study. I began to work. You know what I did? I took all the messages I could get from him. I studied so hard. I started pushing myself like crazy. The next time we met, 8 years later, when we met with Miles Monroe, we were supposed to be speaking together at the conference. You know what happened? I was going to be the first speaker. He was the second. By the time I finished speaking, Miles Monroe said, there is no need for me to come to the stage anymore. There is nothing for me to speak. I just want to hear this man on and over again. And he gave me all his speaking time. He just said, I just want to soak him from this. Because he had been coming to me, but he had never heard me. You see, when you train yourself, when you work hard on yourself, even the people you are looking up onto as God, you will discover that you are not worse than them. So before he died, Vice Monroe sent me a note and said, Pastor Sunday, I want to come and see you again. That was before he died, just 2 months before, 1 month before he died. He sent me that note in October, and he died in November, I think. And he said, I want to come and see you again. You are the most strategic Christian or Christian leader, a kingdom leader I've ever met in my life. You are the most strategic person I know in Christianity today. And he couldn't make it, he died. But I'm going to see him. The point I'm trying to say is that when you think that I am good, you could be better than me. if you will just tax yourself, you know. Then also, that was before then, before Miles Monroe, I met T.L. Osborne. That was another man that blew my socks off. It so much impressed me with his work and presence, with the way he carried God. I got all his messages that I could get, and I spent the next 2 years spending 14 hours a day when in my solitude, just listening to him. I listened to everything I could listen. I listened to all his messages 7 times. By the time we met with T.L. Osborne the next time, T.L. Osborne said, you know what, I'm going to be the one introducing you. He said, you know everything I know. At 72, at 78, you already know everything that I know. And you are just less than 40. And he said, Pastor Sunday, there's nothing for me to teach you anymore. I'm going to sit in America. He sat down, introduced me, left the stage, and put me on stage. And that was, that's another thing for me to discover, that when you work hard, even the heroes, the people that you thought you would never meet up with, hard work will tell you that you have as much treasure in yourself too. That you don't have worse, you are not worse than anyone. That so much treasure is in you as much as in the best of men. You know, you can be as good as anybody if you can work as much as they work. Then I started, you know, getting bored with church life, just doing the church life alone. Because I wanted to not just be a local champion in the church world. I wanted to, you know, be, you know, God's representative, God's champion in every sphere of influence. So I started expanding my coast. I started adding value to myself to be able to speak to political leaders, to be able to speak to economic leaders. So when I read the book of Donald Trump, I discovered that, no, I can be better than this guy, even financially. So I gave myself a target that, because I was not a millionaire, even though I was having a big church, but I didn't have money. So I gave myself a target that in 2 years I'll become a millionaire. But my greatest pride today is I didn't do it in 2 years, I did it in 9 months. Why? Because the treasure was already in me, you see. I needed to develop myself. I needed to add value to myself. But that is not my biggest pride. My biggest pride is that, you know, I said if I was able to become a millionaire, I would raise up millionaires. And in 3 years, I raised up 200 other millionaires. Why? This is all possible because, you know, there is nothing impossible. If you could work hard, 2 years of hard work didn't just make me to become a millionaire and make my church a millionaire church, but to raise up 200 other millionaires. Then, okay, that is because in Christianity, we used to hear people say, you know, just face your calling or just do church and you will never, you know, don't be distracted. And they just limit you as if you can only have one gift, you can only have one capacity, and they think every other thing is a distraction. So don't you try to go and do any other thing. No, I discovered that, no, I have much more potential in me. I discovered that if there is God in me, God is limitless. If God is limitless, I'm limitless. If God is, you know, you're great and I have him in me, I am also supposed to be great. Not just in one area. God is great in every area. You also can be great in every area. That's what I discovered. So I threw away all those deception and those kind of doctrine that says that you can only be good in one topic. So I started developing one after the other. So after I conquered the world of, in my own mind, at least to the length that I wanted it, the world of money, finances, I also wanted to conquer the world of political power, the political influence. So I started developing myself, adding value to me, to myself in that area. You know what? I discovered that it is easy to be at the top of your game, even in political realm. So I started traveling. I discovered that in the next few years, after I started adding to myself value and working on myself, I discovered that it's easy. I saw myself speaking in the United Nations. Number one time, then I met with the United Nations Secretary General, and then I went again. They invited me back again to speak in the United Nations to all the presidents and ambassadors and everybody. It is easy. It is possible if you work hard on yourself. Then I discovered I was speaking in the Japanese parliament, then in the Senate of Israeli Senate, you know, parliament. You know, I started, you know, discovering that everybody wanted to listen to me. And, you know, prime ministers began to give their lives. Presidents began to give their lives. In one-on-one talk with me, I discovered that there's no human being that I talk to that will not be ready to give their lives because they are fascinated by the depth and by the wisdom just by working on yourself. Then I discovered, well, America is, you know, if you're a preacher and all the big names are coming from America and I'm not on television and I'm not on this network and all that, that, you know, I want to go there and see, is it hard there? I discovered that it's the easiest of things. After going to America for 6 months, I was already invited to the Parliament of America, to the Congress. But Congress was, that's everybody goes to Congress. But I got myself invited to the Senate. And I was in the Senate speaking to the Senate. Only 100 people are there in the Senate. Only 100 in America. And they were there listening to this young man from Idomila. And you know why? Because I added so much value to myself. I was in demand now. You see, what I'm saying is that there is no limit for you. I kept on, this is just how, through hard work, I've discovered myself. Just like David discovered himself through hard work, he became the shepherd of Israel. Through hard work that he had done, you know, fighting the bears and the lions, he became the killer of Goliath. Through hard work that he did upon himself, he got himself into the palace of Saul. Through hard work, he became the king of Israel. You know, look at Joseph. You know, people were while his brothers were mocking him and taunting him that he's just a dreamer, he kept on working on himself. So by his hard work, he got to work in the house of Potiphar, of course they had some accusations and false accusations against him. But even when he was put in prison, he didn't stop working. He kept on working hard in prison, and injustice continued in prison, but he kept on working hard, and through hard work, he got out of that place. Hard work got him out of there. And also, through hard work, he became the prime minister of Egypt. Hard work. That hard work discovered that he was not a dreamer anyway. Through hard work, he discovered that he was not a dreamer after all. Through hard work, he discovered that he was not a dreamer. No, he was not a dreamer. He brought his dream to pass through hard work. I don't know what dream you are having right now. I don't know what dream God has put in your heart. Maybe you are thinking you are a dreamer. Maybe other people are thinking you are a dreamer. But through hard work, your dream will become reality. Just like the dream of David became reality. Just like the dream of Joseph became your reality. Just like the dream of Daniel became reality. Can you see the hard work that Daniel did? Daniel did all kind of hard work as well. You know, I told you there are three forms of work. That is spiritual work, mental work, and physical work. You know, Daniel made sure he engaged himself in all these forms of work. And you know what? He became the governor in Babylon because of hard work. There is nothing, no matter what is against you, no matter how who is against you, if you will just add value to yourself, if you will just, you know, add value and create value, if you will focus and make yourself to become a man of value, creating value to yourself and for yourself and adding value for other people and to other people, there is no limit for you. Sky is your limit. Let me just tell you something right now. If you will take even all my messages, all these daily messages that we do, that I've done, go to sundayadelajahblog.com. Go and look for the video blog. Download or get, you know, to listen to all these messages that I've preached there. If you listen to them 4 times, 5 times each, and by the time you listen to 200 of these messages, you will be the best in the world, no matter what you do. Either you want to be a scientist, you'll become the best. Either you want to be an inventor, you'll become the best. Either you want to be a businessman, you'll become the best. Either you're going to be a preacher, you'll be the best. Either you're going to be a pastor, you're going to be the best. You know, if you will work hard, if you will not pity yourself and work hard on yourself, can you imagine? See, these are some of my books here. This is my book on Nigeria. If you want to get all these books, this is my book on the kingdom. This is my book on how to discover yourself. This is my book on churchship. This is my book on money will make you rich. This is my book on my small role. Now, all these books, these are nothing. I have over 300 books already. But unfortunately, 300 of them are in Russian language. But we have them translated to English, but we need somebody to help us edit them. So if you are there and you are curious and you want to learn more, you want to get more of my materials, and you want to help us, because can you imagine me? I cannot, you know, pay for all just the correction of all these books. They will be too expensive. So that's why I'm not doing them yet. But if I could find volunteers, if you are ready to work and help us to edit some of these books and put them in proper English, it will be some of the greatest blessings for yourself and for the world as well. So if you are interested in helping me, not just translate, we have the translation, but to correct some of these, or rewrite some of these books in English, in proper English, to bless the world, please write me. My email is pastor@godembassy.org. 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 So you know, if you could edit, you have no English very well, write me and we're going to give you and you are going to help us. But if you are just a writer and you are a writer, you are a good writer and you don't want to correct, but you want to write. I have so many, all these messages that I'm preaching, I think we should give them, we should convert them to books. And I'm looking for writers as well. Those I will pay if you want, if you need money, I'll pay you for that, for the writers to convert the books to English language. I mean, to a book. So if you are interested in converting, in helping convert some of these messages to books as well, write me to the same address, pastor@godembassy.org. And I'm going back to Africa. I want to go and prove that Africa could be resurrected, and that Africa could be delivered, that Africa could be salvaged. So I'm going back to Africa, and I want to bring about transformation of Africa in my own lifetime. Not the whole of Africa, but starting from Nigeria. So if you want to join that team, go to my blog, sundayadelajablog.com/Africa, and you have a form there. You have to go and register there. Go and register in that form that you want to become a part of Pastor Sunday Adelaja team. If you want to be a part of people who change the world, and you want to witness how a nation is changed, and you want to become a partner, don't worry about your expenses and everything else, but just come. You must come with an idea of what you want to do in Africa. Then join us and we'll get back in touch with you. But if you have not shared this link yet, please go look for your share button right now. Go look for your share button, and I want you to share this button right now. I want you to share this message. Just press the share button, then you'll be able to have a copy of it. You get a copy for yourself of this message. It will come to your timeline. It will come to your timeline, and then other people will be able to watch it as well. You'll be a blessing to other people. So share the message, and I want to hear your impressions, because my time is up. You can't believe it. My time is up. It's 1 hour already. It's unbelievable. It's 1 hour. Let me see what you are writing. I want to hear your impressions. I want to hear what you are thinking about this, what you are hearing. I want to hear what are your decisions, and what lasting legacy is this message going to create in your life. I want to hear what you think, what your thoughts are, and what your decisions are. Olabisi Olushoga said, "Thank God you are giving us this teaching, Dr. Sunday. God bless and protect you. You are my dream come true." Oh, wow. God protect you. Thank you, Olavisi. Wesley Dodi say, "Please, sir, please include India in your list as well." Okay. Christopher Abik say, "Hard work is the key. Man of God, nobody is like you to tell the people of God the truth. We are blessed to have you 2 times a day. Thank you, Christopher. Comfy said, "No more limitations." Yes. Glory to God. Marianne says, best testimony in video ever. Thank you. How blessed and privileged we are to have you as mentor. Audu says, "Add values and create value." Thank you, Jesus. Pastor, you are the best thing that happened to our generation. Thank you. The books are always upside down. Yes, I don't know why. I think it's a problem either with my computer or with mentions that I'm using. Ojuolakwe said, "By hard work, the discovery of who I am is made." Yes. Becky Williams, "You inspire me, sir." Thank you, Becky. By the way, some of you have been asking, when can you come? How could you come and, you know, get to learn from me and come and study here in Ukraine? You know, we have this event twice a year, and the last one we're going to have this year is coming up in November. It's called History Makers Training. I train history makers. So if you want to become a history maker and you want to be trained with Pastor Sunday, get 10 days out or 8 days out. It's from 6th of November to the 12th of November. 6th to the 12th of November. You know, you can write to guest@godembassy.org. Guest, G-U-E-S-T, at godembassy.org. guest@godembassy.org. Right there and tell them that you want to come and be part of the History Makers training. We'll be happy to have you and receive you in Ukraine. TY says, no matter what or who is against you, if you will just add value to yourself, you have no limits. Yep, that is so true. Shiju Ade says, hard work is the key to great success, right? Immaculate said, through hard work, my dream will become a reality. Sure. Bukola Olushoga said, discover the hidden treasure in you through the power of hard work. Thank you, Pastor Sunday, for motivating us daily. Jumbo says, you will be on demand without boundaries when you give yourself to tireless hard work, right? Rochelle White is strategic for this time and this generation. Praise God. Anastasia said, there is no limit for me now, right? Angela said, through hard work, you will discover yourself and be a sought after. Your background has no limit on who you can become, right? Cecile says, you motivate me to work on myself. Thank you, Dr. Sunday. To be a blessing for us. Josephine Onabo, I'm so motivated to continue working on myself. Thank you, Pastor. Rochelle said, thank you for teaching us how to. Morenike says, if I have in me, I should be limitless because God is limitless. Yes. Afa Mefuna Ezeja said, and I am here ready to follow you. Make millionaire out of me. No, you will make millionaire out of yourself. I've already given and provided all the tools for you to become a millionaire. If you don't know it, look, this book is called Money Won't Make You Rich. And people are already becoming millionaires just reading this book. Moreover, you have all my teachings on how to become a millionaire, or the loss of money. I don't call it how to become a millionaire, but the loss of money and the financial principles and empowerment, they are there on my blog. Go to sundayadelajablog.com and you'll be able to go through the video blog and see the playlist, and you see all the teachings on finances there. There are 50 or 50 something of them. If you listen to those ones, for all the 50 of them, four times each, you will not just become a millionaire, you become a billionaire. And you can go to YouTube and the playlist there, and you can find those teachings as well there. All the financial teachings that I did, if you will listen to those things four times each, you will not just become a millionaire, you become a billionaire. Repeat me, quote me. Shigo Nwafo, seeds of greatness to create forests of all kinds with unlimited potential is in us. Kike Moronkeji, no wonder, Pastor Sunday, your teachings are so fresh and inspiring because you work on yourself. I'm motivated to work on myself. Patrick Christian, Galatians 2:6, the influential leaders didn't add anything to what I was preaching. Eucharia, so proud of you, Pastor. Thank you for all you do. This message reminds me of Easter egg hunt. All the treasures are hidden in us. Yes. Keith Turner said, this is not of the flesh, but of the spirit. Thank God. Triumphant said, my pastor, these teachings are simply wow. Because here in Nigeria, it's just church, pray. Lonzo Graham says, I like you the way you can keep the good work up. Lara Shomoye said, it is erroneous to think that favor is all you need while neglecting hard work, right? Wesley Dodi said, you are a composition of truth and spirit embodiment practically. Thank you. Noel Okushuku, this message is a measure for measuring ourselves if we are lazy or not. No excuse for failure. Comfort Ekundayo, since I have been listening to you, Pastor, my life has begun to take a new way. I'm going to work as hard on myself as possible. Christina Lampe, Pastor, you have become my world mentor. Through you, I have discovered more callings in my life. Ushe Alfred, thank you, sir. I've been scared to take a decision as a pastor to invest my finance, but because of the conventional doctrine, I was told or something. Feel is meek. It is impossible to stay discouraged listening to you. I feel like a treasure box ready to pop open. Adewale Emmanuel, it's time to work. Okay, Udo. This is another revelation and quite revolutionary. I'm once equipped in my conviction for success. I must be part of this revelation. By the way, listen, everyone. Stop. Announcement to all of you. Please, just listen to this, what I'm about to say now. Please, anything you are doing right now, drop it. Just listen to me right now. You must listen to me. I forgot to tell you this. Tonight, 7 p.m., you drop anything you are doing. Just find all the time you can find tonight. 7 p.m. British time, 7 p.m. Nigerian time, 2 p.m. American time, Eastern time. Tonight, 2 p.m. American time today, and 7 p.m. British time, 7 p.m. Nigerian time today. I am going to be coming on live, and I'm coming with a unique, incredible person. You remember the story, if you have read my book or you've read my story or you've heard me, you remember I told one of the first women that came to me when I started to preach, and I asked her what was her name, and she said her name was Natasha Alcoholic. You remember that name, Natasha Alcoholic? That woman, the Natasha Alcoholic, she's now a big woman, missionary, apostle. She's now in Germany, but she's coming back. She's actually in my house right now. And she's going to be with me tonight to tell her story. You can't believe it. If anybody were to be dead, if you consider yourself as dead already, a story will bring you alive and will give you hope and will make you to believe that there is nothing you cannot do. This woman came to me when she was about 40, and today. And she drank for 30 years. She was alcoholic for 30 years. Today, if you hear what she's doing, you will beat yourself hard. So come and listen to our story tonight, 7 p.m. British time and 7 p.m. Nigerian time as well. Adewale said, I will put in more hard work for myself to become relevant in the society and my generation. Mabel Ambuge, I like watching your video time and time again, for they inspire me. Becky, it happens with everyone who displays print. It's a mirror image. Okay. Apostle Yomi says, this is one of the best motivational words I've ever listened to. This is indeed a blessing, and there is no one that can... I didn't see that. Gregory, Pastor, you just fired me up again. You will hear my testimony soon. Amen. I'm waiting. Nkem says, I will be there by God's grace. That's in November. Raymond Obi, you have blown my mind to the next level. I pray it is not too late to start on this next level. Noel Okushuku said, this message is immeasurable. It's an honor to be delivered and not left like that, but empowered to be filled to do greatness. At your delay, I will start working hard to be greater in changing my world. Timothy Jayola, I have learned that I can one day stand on the same stage with you through hard work. Thank you, sir. You are just too abnormal. King Femi Daniel said, Pastor Sunday is a limit breaker. Koyejo Oduola said, what a heart God has given you to share this word of experience with us. Thank you. Afa Mefuna, Doctor, how about the mentoring program that I saw on your website? I also already filled the form. When is it taking time? You know, I'm giving so much now. I'm giving two messages every day. That's why we stopped the mentoring session, because you don't have time. You know, if he overloads you, you will not have time for anything else. You just find time first to consume all this daily teaching, and that will be awesome for you. Wesley Dodi, awesome sharing, sir. So honest, authentic, and practical teaching. Fumi Jeboda, God bless you for including me in your mentoring and letting us know excellence can only be achieved through hard work. Ludovic, through hard work, dreams become reality. Yep. Evangelist Muji, thanks very much, sir. God richly bless you. Praying for more anointing. I appreciate you, sir. Thank you. Boniface Heart, my spirit, my soul, and body is telling me to work, work, and work hard. Akintola Abiodun, deciding to do all I can to bring about a change and a fulfilled dream and vision. Thank God. Frankie Lucero, God bless you. Angela, you are truly a blessing, sir. Your message this morning just confirmed what God told me this morning during my devotion. Mabel, thank for these great works and teaching, more anointing and grace. Thank you. Kike, no wonder, Pastor Sunday, your teachings are so fresh. Okay, we've heard that. Steve Osarete, thank you, Pastor. You have just proved to us that through hard work, nothing is impossible. Abiodun Elijah, abnormal people produce excellent results. Gift blessing. Thank you, Doctor, for always, God always channel through you to us, river in people's heart, especially me, His grace. In fact, I'm already, Ushe, truly you make us take responsibility for our lives. Thanks, success is a choice. Frank Shi, you have a refreshing personality. What is the website? The website is is Sunday Adelaja. That's my name. Sunday Adelaja blog.com. Sunday Adelaja blog.com. Tracy Taylor, I called myself the billionaire in training, so I'm in the right place, right? Mary Mugure, in Kenya, I grew up being taught to tithe and pray, but never taught to work. You have really worked on me, and I'm back on my feet again. Noel, why does fear challenges the mind that wants to practice this message? Okay, what should one do to break out of this fear? Well, that is what I just told you. When I was going to Africa, I was afraid that I would not be able to match up with the top apostle there. But when I walked on myself, walk brings confidence and it removes the fear. When I was going to, to the U.S. Senate, I thought, what would I be able to tell these politicians? I was afraid. But because I walked on myself, walk removed that. I was afraid of my exam because I worked on myself, worked to remove the fear. If you work and add more value to your day, more added value you've created in yourself, it will remove the fear. Fear is a proof that you don't have enough knowledge. And if you have, you don't have enough confidence. If you have enough confidence, you have, if you have enough knowledge, you have enough confidence. And if you have enough confidence, you will not have fear. TY says, oh my God, I cannot wait to meet Natasha. She is going to be here tonight. And if you have not shared this link yet, you want to get a copy of this message, share it on your link. That is the way to get a copy. Great, great Femi. Pastor, you just fired me up again. You will hear my testimony very soon. Okay, by the grace of God, it's going to happen. Ife Omar says, I can't get enough of your teaching, Pastor, because it's really life-changing to me. Christina Lampe says, Pastor, you are the resurrection and the life to the world. Yeah, because Jesus is me. Jesus is the life and resurrection of the world, but he's in me and he's in you too. We should be able to be the same like him. The more we behold him, the more we become like him. Nkem Dike said, we just have no excuse. We just have no excuses. We have greatness in us and can only be discovered through hard work. I must work harder on myself. Christopher said, Doctor, I'm one of your students through Professor Vincent in the UK, but I'm living in Gothenburg, Sweden. Your message is turning Sweden upside down. Glory to God. Immaculate said, thank you, Pastor, for deciding to go to Africa. Africa really needs you. I will always pray for that mission. Thank you. De Bafu, believe God of all the promises is the rewarder of hard work. I am starting and looking forward to show the result of my salvation. Glory Baye, it's time to roll up our sleeves and get to work. No more self-limitations, no more self-pity. God has already blessed us with so much. Matthew, I say, Pastor, this message is inspirational and my life is not going to be the same. We work hard to visit you in November. Noel says, no comment. Going to work out this message till the message works me out. Thank you, Pastor. My wife is glad I listen to you now. Elizabeth, Pastor, all I can say is that you thank you. If you can do it, then I have no excuse. Love you a lot. Thank you, Elizabeth. Mary Oben, thank you, sir, for this morning meal. It's high time I work on myself. I'm stirred and challenged this morning. Wesley says, sir, I miss your saying, work hard as if, pray hard as if, oh yeah, work hard as if you don't know how to pray, as if God does not exist. Work hard as if God does not exist, as if prayer does not exist, as if everything depends on the hard work. And pray hard as if you didn't work at all, as if everything depends on the prayer. Becky Williams, I only search out the authentic. I can hear the difference in the tone, in the voice. Thank you, Becky. Lonzo says, actually, all my life I've been working hard, but listen to you, that gave the fire to keep on working. Evangelist Muji, I learned that nobody is dull in life if only he will work out to bring out the greatness in him. Yep. Matthias said, this is the best motivation ever in my life. Bernd Stenmetz, you inspired me this morning and your message is a divine appointment. Thank you for your daily messages. I'm motivated. Thank you. Aldo say, Pastor, I like your background. I was hearing some birds making melody behind. Thank you for this timely work. I will work. TY say, work brings confidence and removes fear, right? Immaculate, fear is the proof of lack of knowledge, yes. Okay, guys, you know what? It's time to leave. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for your time. If you don't have my books or you want to help translate or interpret some of these books, no, not interpret, correct. If you want to help us work on the correction of some of the books in proper English, write to me, pastor@godembassy.org. If you are a professional writer and you'd like to help convert some of these messages to books, you can also write me at pastor@godembassy.org. And I will see you tonight. Pastor Natasha Alcoholic is going to be here with us tonight. Wow, you need to listen to that woman. Anything you must do, call your friends, call everybody you want to. Make sure you come here tonight, 7 p.m. British time, 7 p.m. Nigerian time, 2 p.m. Eastern time in America. Thank you so much. Thank you for this message. Thank you for being here for this message. I hope it has changed your life. It's capable of doing it, but I hope you just go for it. I hope you just not just be here as alone, but you will do as of the world. God bless you now. Bye.